Very good morning to all the students of class 9th D. Yes, Vita. We are doing chapter My Childhood, which is an extract from very renowned book, which is autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. He has written his about his childhood, about his studies, about his background, his family. Fine. The name of that book is Wings of Fire, and your chapter is an extract from that book only. You will be getting a glance from that book. Today I have written something on the board, which is very, you know, making the crux of that book. So every one of you kindly note down. You know, you can see the quote of the day is, it takes courage to show up and become who you really are. Fine. APJ Abdul Kalam never hesitated of showing his true self. He sold newspaper, he sold tamarind seeds even. Even then he never hesitated. He was not ashamed of helping his parents when he was 8 years old, 13 years old. He was a teenager only. Fine. So he accepted it beautifully. He accepted his background. One should be humble enough and never forget. Though he became president, even then he remained very grounded throughout his life till his last breath. Fine. So I have written something that I would be explaining to you, and then we will continue with the reading. Okay. So after this, those who have joined now, beta, please join well in time. It's your loss only. So I have written theme in one line. You can see our life is shaped by our experiences and the people around us. Yes. So what is the theme of this chapter, My Childhood? That day we discussed about the characters and the background and all. Now I'm just discussing what is the theme. Fine. Our life is shaped by our experiences and the people around us. Yes, this is one of the messages given by this chapter, My Childhood. That what sort of people are surrounding you. That's why, you know, they say that keep good company. Choose your friends wisely. The kind of company we keep, we are known by it only. So in this chapter, APJ Abdul Kalam had, note down, beta. Secure childhood. His parents provided him secure childhood. Then inspiring parents. He had inspiring parents who kept on inspiring him, encouraging him. Fine. Then supportive friends. Next is I already told you there were four friends altogether. He was having three more friends. There were many friends later on, but I'm talking about childhood friends. They were very supportive. Then honest teachers. His teachers were very honest, very, you can say, talented, grounded. And that's why he was surrounded by such kind of people. So that's why I've written an order. This is the theme. Our life is shaped by experiences and the people around us. This is what APJ Abdul Kalam had, and which instilled great values in him. Fine. And because of these people and these experiences in his life, he instilled great values and gave him wings of fire. Actually, the name of the book is there, but I have written in that way that how he got his wings. It doesn't mean literally one is flying with wings. Yes, one should fly. And how you can fly? When people surrounding you are pushing you to next level, encouraging you, motivating you, taking stand for you. Fine, then you can get wings of fire. So this is the name of his actual book, Wings of Fire, Autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. So this is very, you can say, in that way I have written. So kindly note down whatever I have written on the board, theme, and what sort of life APJ Abdul Kalam had. That's why this is the crux of this chapter, My Childhood. He has shared fine experiences of his childhood with you all and how he became what he is known today. So your childhood matters a lot. Your experiences matter a lot. What you become later in your life. Clear? I hope everybody has noted down. Can you show me? I'm just checking. If anybody has noted down the value point, all my praise go to that child. Let me check in between. Anybody has written anything? Can show me the notebook? Riyanshika is the first one. Yes, very good. Divya has noted down on the book. Very good. Dharya Chadda has noted down. Well done, beta. Those who are noting down, beta, it's not for me. Surveen is also noting down. Fine. So it's my idea of naming you all. Yes, Titiksha is also, she has started noting down maybe. Yes, if it's visible to you, I'm just sitting the way you can read the board also. Okay. So these points will help you when you will be preparing for your exams. Find value points or theme or characters. On very first day, we do characters. So you must note everything written on the board. I specially prepare for you people. And if you will not note down it, that will be your loss only. So let's not waste time. Let's continue reading. I would be showing you one video also today. So stay there. Yes, it's okay, Diksha. Now no need to show. We are not going to waste much time in notebooks only. Let's continue, okay? Every child is born with some inherited characteristics. If any problem is there, beta, you can write in the chat box. Kindly don't speak in between, okay? You can write in the chat box if you have any problem, okay? So every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. So APJ Abdul Kalam is going to tell you about his childhood. He's going to tell that what sort of, you can say, qualities he inherited from his parents, what traits he inherited. So underline, I inherited honesty and self-discipline from my father. His father was very self-disciplined and honest. So he inherited this trait from his father. From my mother, I inherited faith. I inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness, and so did my three brothers and sister. Underline this. He's telling us about his family also. Ramanand Shastri, Arvindan and Shiv Prakashan. I had three close friends in my childhood. So underline these names. Very first day I introduced these characters to you. They are going to play a very prominent part in his life. Clear? So these are the people who surrounded APJ Abdul Kalam. So they are going to play an important role in his life. Clear? Why he inherited kindness from his mother? Because his mother was very kind lady, used to feed others, poor people, whatsoever she was having, the meager amount of food, she would share with others. Fine. Father was very good disciplinarian and follower of rules. So he inherited those traits. And we people learn by seeing our parents and people surrounding us. I had three close friends, fine, Ramanand Shastri, Arvindan and Shiprakashan. All these boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Orthodoxes means rigid. As children, none of us ever felt any difference amongst ourselves because of our religious differences and upbringing. Now comes the point. APJ Abdul Kalam hailed from Muslim family. He was not Hindu. He was not from Sikh background. He was a Muslim. And these friends of his, they hailed from Hindu Brahmin families, but they never ever made any kind of difference. Neither their parents, nor their teachers, nor themselves created any kind of difference. In fact, Ramanand Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri. Underline beta this name, because this priest is going to play a very important role. I would be showing one video related to this, you can say, incident also. So Ramanand Shastri was best friend of APJ Abdul Kalam, and he was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the high priest of Rameshwaram temple. The temple was very famous, Rameshwaram temple, and he was the head priest of that temple. Fine. Who? Lakshman Shastri. And Ramanand Shastri is the name of his son. Later, he took over the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple from his father. So you can see, they were priests. They would enjoy everything, every religious ceremony. Though he was, they were Muslim and Brahmin family, and they were relishing every act together. You can see APJ Abdul Kalam here wearing this cap, fine, and his friend Ramanand Shastri enjoying and dancing on the beating of the drums. His family and all are together celebrating. Our family used to arrange boats for carrying idols for the Lord from the temple to the marriage site. See, they were not thinking that Hindu idols, and even family of APJ Abdul Kalam would carry those idols during the puja and all. So there was no difference, no religious differences, no any discrimination of caste and creed. Then he's saying, later he took over the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple from his father. Who? His friend. Arvindan went into the business. So he's telling about a bit of information about his friends. Next friend is Arvindan. He went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims. Fine. He's telling that which business was adopted by, which job was adopted by which friend. Okay. So Ramanand Shastri became priest. Arvindan went into family business. And Shiv Prakashan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. So his third friend named Shiv Prakashan became a catering contractor. Then during the annual Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, our family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site. So APJ Abdul Kalam's family would arrange boats so that they can carry idols, situated in the middle of the pond called Ram Tirath, which was near our house. Events from the Ramayana and from the life of the prophet were the bedtime stories my mother and grandmother would tell the children in our family. So this is very important, beta. You know, when we were kids, our parents would tell us tales, stories, or bedtime stories. Mother and grandmother of APJ Abdul Kalam, they never thought that we would be narrating stories related to only prophets and Muslim people and Muslim backgrounds. They told APJ Abdul Kalam stories from Ramayana also, as well as from the life of prophets also. Fine. So they were not differentiating on the grounds of religion at all at that time. One day, now beta, this is the incident I was talking about. I would be showing you. Let's read first, then we will watch this video. One day, when I was in the fifth standard at the Rameshwaram Elementary School is the school for junior kids, fine? A new teacher came to our class. I used to wear a cap which marked me as a Muslim, and I always sat in the front row next to Ramanand Shastri, who wore the sacred thread. So this is the scene of carrying boats, how they would carry boats by decorating it for the lords of, for Hindu festivals. So next is, now the incident says, APJ Abdul Kalam as a child would wear cap because he was a Muslim, and his friend Ramanand Shastri would wear sacred thread. We called it janeu, fine. He would wear the thread that shows that he was a Brahmin. The new teacher came. New teacher was not at all aware that these teachers and students and parents are very, you know, having a broad-minded view, and they never mind sitting together. They were not differentiating. So this new teacher could not stomach a Hindu priest's son, could not stomach means could not digest or could not tolerate. He thought, how a Hindu priest's son sitting with a Muslim boy in the first row, in accordance with our social ranking, as the new teacher saw, I was asked to go and sit on the back bench. Very shameful act it is. So teacher thought, a Muslim and a Hindu Brahmin boy sitting together, I should ask this Muslim boy to sit at last. And Hindu Brahmin families are considered upper caste families, and he's a Muslim, he should go and sit at last. So never it happened in history. That was the first teacher, new teacher. He asked APJ Abdul Kalam and get up and go and sit at the back bench. I felt very sad. Who's I? This is the narration given by A.P.J. Abdul Kalam himself. He says he felt very embarrassed, very sad, very dejected. And so did Ramanand Shastri, his friend also. Obviously, when you remember when you were sitting together in the class and you talk a lot. Our reason is that you talk a lot, then we say, okay, get up and go to the next bench. Our reason is that you're disturbing the class. But this reason is not at all worth, you know, acceptable. He looked utterly downcast as I shifted to my seat in the last row. His friend Ramanand Shastri became very sad. The image of him weeping, both of them started crying. APJ was crying at the last desk. Ramanand Shastri was crying at the first desk. Small children of just class fifth. I shifted to the last row, left a lasting impression on me. After school, see, this book was written when he was adult. And how he remembered how teacher treated. So the way we treat people, it goes long way. Bitter memories we carry in our hearts. So we should be very careful while dealing with small children. After school, we went home and told our respective parents about the incident. Lakshman Shastri summoned the teacher, called the teacher, Lakshman Shastri. Who's Lakshman Shastri? Father of Ramanand Shastri. His, you can say his friend's father. He was the head priest of Rameshwaram temple. He, when heard about this incident, he called the teacher there and then, and in our presence, in the presence of the students, he told the teacher that don't spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance. What does it mean? Social inequality means don't create differences on the basis of caste, religion. We have taught our kids in a better way. We teach them daily that we all are equal. And you, the new people, a new person here, teaching them social inequality, communal intolerance. In the minds of innocent children, this is the poisonous thing. He bluntly asked the teacher to either apologize or quit the school and the island. He says, either you have to apologize to these children, what you have done, or you have to quit the school. Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshman Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed this young teacher. So this teacher realized his mistake. He regretted his act of creating difference among the minds, you can say, among us, those children. So then, that time onwards, this teacher started treating all children equally. Now Ramanand, along with his friend APJ Abdul Kalam, sitting together in first row. I always sat in the front row next to Ramanand Shastri. So they were happy now. Fine. So on the whole, the small society of Rameshwaram was very rigid in terms of the segregation of different social groups. Though they were in ancient times, but they were very much particular. They never taught their children that you are Brahmin, you are Muslim, and you should not talk to him, you should not eat his food. No, they were very good people. Fine. So society of Rameshwaram was, though they were rigid, but they were not in favor of segregation, you know, creating different groups. However, my science teacher, this is better, another now incident going to start about science teacher and his wife, that we will not read. Fine. Before proceeding, I would like to show you one small video about this act of teacher. This is actually a true incident. So let's relish this small video. So I would be speaking here. He's telling that APJ Abdul Kalam was staying there in Rameshwaram. And there was a temple near mosque only. So you can see this Rameshwaram temple was very famous one. And APJ Abdul Kalam, you know, would go there daily, and some people would stare at him. That why this Muslim boy standing in front of a temple? The reality was, he loved to listen to the rhythmic chants and mantras, that melodious, you know, voices coming from that temple. So he was getting allured or attracted towards those voices. And one more reason, that his friend Ramanand Shastri, his best friend Ramanand Shastri, he was the son of the head priest Lakshman Shastri. Fine. So both, they would pay homage to gods, they would recite hymns together, and then, you know, they would see, you can see how those friends are relishing their relation. And then they would go to school and they would sit together on the very first bench, in the very first row. They were best friends. So Ramanand Shastri and this boy, APJ Abdul Kalam. And they never thought that he is priest and I am Muslim. He would wear sacred thread and he would wear this cap. They have highlighted, you can see. So it was clearly visible that he is a Muslim and he is a Brahmin by seeing their attire only, by seeing their clothes. So a new teacher came to the class one day. He was a very strict teacher. And he went around the class tapping his cane on his palm and stopped before us. When he saw that one boy wearing white cap, he's a Muslim, how dare you sit here with the temple priest's son? He started shouting at him. And he just instructed him, go and sit at the last bench. He felt very hurt. He started crying. He picked up his books and shifted to the last row because it was the instruction of the teacher. Both of them were very sad. Coming back together at home, they thought that they will never sit together anymore because this new teacher will never allow them. APJ Abdul Kalam reached very dejected at home, and his father noticed it. He told everything to his father. His father asked him, why are you crying? Why are you sad? He narrated the whole incident while crying to his father. Same happened with this boy, Ramanand Shastri. He just explained everything to his father. So immediately, you know, that boy came to APJ Abdul Kalam's house and called him that, come to my house immediately. He thought, what happened? He was scared for some more trouble. Then when they went back, they saw a teacher, that same teacher was called there by the head priest. He was scared. In the light of our discussion, apologize to Kalam here. So head priest said, this is very bad on your part that you are spreading social inequality. APJ Abdul Kalam could not believe that this is happening in front of him. So he taught a lesson. No child is less in God's eyes. It is your duty as a teacher to help students live in harmony, to not create the differences in the background, in the dresses, the way they talk or they do preaching, fine? So this is then teacher apologized that he realized that this is very wrong because, you know, students follow their teachers. So he hugged APJ Abdul Kalam, he felt sorry, and he learned a big lesson. Fine, that from that day onwards, he sincerely regretted. That was good on teacher's part. And he permitted to continue both of them to sit together, and he never created, and both of them were happy always together, you know. And they were sitting on the first bench and they remained best friends together. Clear? I hope you like this story because when we watch it, we remember it always. How many of you enjoyed watching this session? Kindly send me thumbs up so that I can keep on adding such videos in future also. Okay, so you are enjoying it. Now, after enjoying a bit, I guess, let's continue. A few minutes are left, Beta. Let's continue our. So I told you, on the whole, the small society of Rameshwaram was very rigid in terms of segregation of different social groups. So this society of Rameshwaram never believed in creating different groups on the basis of religion and all. Then next incident, beta, mark it. The incident of that, you know, making him sit at the back bench is over now. Now next is science teacher. Seva Subramania. Now, how to pronounce such big names? You will be, you know, just segregating these words. This is Seva Subramania. Fine. So Seva Subramania Iyer. This is the name of science teacher. Underline this. Though an orthodox Brahmin, he was also a Brahmin. You can say orthodox Brahmin family was coming from, but he was not conservative. Fine, though he belonged to this community, but he was not conservative. He was having broader viewpoints. That science teacher was very good. But problem was that his wife was very conservative. You know, conservative means the people who think within few limits only, again, creating differences on the basis of religion. She was something of a rebel. Fine, rebel as a person, if you say do this, he will do the opposite of that thing. Fine, if you will say sit, rebel will stand. So we call okay, so next class has started sending request. I guess time is there, only 1 minute is left. So I'm just giving you gist that his wife was very conservative. He did his best to break social barriers so that people from varying backgrounds could mingle easily. He used to spend hours with me and would say, Kalam, I want you to develop so that you are on the par with the highly educated people of the big cities. So this is how science teacher would treat APJ Abdul Kalam. Science teacher knew that he is very good student and he would encourage APJ Abdul Kalam very much. Fine. So tomorrow we would be continuing, beta. Clear? I hope you enjoyed this session. Tomorrow we'll be able to finish this chapter maybe. With this, I'm just going to end this meet. Have a nice day.